There's the graveyard where my mother's buried.
Where are you going?
Come on.
What are we looking for?
There it is.
Your mother's grave.
They have her preserved in an airtight chamber. Her fingerprints will get us into Comstock House.
She's your mother.
A mother who abandons their child doesn't draw a lot of sympathy in my book.
Take a moment to think about what you're doing.
There. Will you open the door or do I have to go in without you?
Elizabeth.
It's her. How are you, Mother? All locked up in there, huh? Looks like you and I have some common ground.
Let me do it.
No.
Let me do it.
Look on the other side.
And he has led you astray. What I do for love. What lion does not cringe to see their cub in pain? But spare the rod, spoil the child. If you won't listen to me, perhaps you will listen to your mother.
Elizabeth, are you all right?
Where did she
go? Hold on, you need to rest for a minute.
No, I'm getting that hand.
Elizabeth, why is your mother a ghost?
She's not. He used me to power that device. He opened up some kind of tear.
Much obliged.
I'll try to stop.
What is she? Alive or dead?
Why do you ask what?
When the delicious question is when.
The only difference between past and present
is semantics.
Lives, lived, will live.
Dies, died, will die.
If we could perceive time as it truly was,
what reason would grammar professors have to get out of bed?
Like us all, Lady Comstock exists across time.
She is both alive and dead.
She perceives being both.
She finds this condition disagreeable.
Perception without comprehension
is a dangerous combination. Look! Footsteps! She goes to unfinished business.
We have to follow her. Convince her to open the gate to Comstock House.
It's a shame you have need of her to enter Comstock House.
Frankly, she doesn't seem all that cooperative.
There is a way to bring her to reason.
Three truths you must discover first.
Truths which, in this world, Comstock has destroyed.
If only one of you had the power to alter time and space.
That would be a blessing, wouldn't it?
Hmm.
Well, they're sarcastic.
There's something off about Lady Comstock.
Yeah. I noticed.
No, you don't understand. She doesn't belong here. I brought something through. I'm not so sure it was her.
Brother, these holes in the thin air continue to pay dividends. I know not which musician you borrow your notes from, but if he has half the genius of the biologist I now observe, well, then you are to be the Mozart of Columbia.
enemies out there.
A lockpick. Grab it.
Elizabeth?
I'll give it a whirl.
Locked.
Okay. Ready.
Stock has sabotaged our contraption. Yet, we are not dead. A theory. We are scattered amongst the possibility space. But my brother and I are together, and so I'm content. He is not. The business with the girl lies unresolved. But perhaps there is one who can finish it in our stead.
Non-existent.
And Madame Lutess.
Furthermore, the man is quite sterile.
It's a lie. Come here, you little bastard! I want her out of my house!
Sterile.
They weren't my parents.
Then what were you to them?
A child that they decided to imprison. She deserved whatever Comstock did to her.
What did you mean before when you said Lady Comstock didn't belong here?
She's almost
feral. It's like she's a reflection of... I don't know.
Comstock seems to have been made sterile by simple exposure to our contraption. A theory. Just as sexual reproduction can de-emphasize the traits of each parent, so goes the effect of multiple realities on our own. Your traits dissipate until they become unrecognizable or cease to exist. Lady Comstock seems to believe the child is a result of some errant act of carnality between myself and her beloved prophet. I told the poor woman the truth, that the child was a product of our little contraption, but I think she found that less believable than her delusion.
Some money. Here you go.
Got a lock, needs picking.
Come on, give me something challenging. All done.
need money? Take this.